it's published in January 1963, Journal of American Concrete Institute. ACI member, Professor Civil Engineering, Department of Civil Engineering, California, Berkeley. And both are the members of the California Berkeley University. उनके आपस में उनकी अचीवमेंट्स हैं, शेल के ऊपर कितना काम किया है. आप यहाँ पे बहुत से ACI कोड के रेफरेंसेज देख रहे होंगे जो अब चेंज हो गए हैं. सो दैट्स वाई आई चूज दिस ओल्ड पेपर. सो इन दिस पेपर दे कंडक्टेड अ सीरीज ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो दीज आर द फोर डिफरेंट सेट्स, OA1, OA2, OA3. These are the three sets of the beams, RCC beams, without any shear reinforcement. B1, B2, B3, they have some shear links. A1, A2, A3, they have the shear links and the top reinforcement as well. The geometry of the A1, OA1 and A1, they are similar. And then they have the C1 beams having small depth as compared, small width as compared to the depth. So these are the four sets. The informations about the material property, about the steel percentage, about their dimensions, about the number of the bar they use, stirrup spacing, they are provided in this table. And then when they conduct it, how they conduct, so this is the stress strain curve of the steel. So I guess in 1963, they don't have the advanced material to find out the stress strain curves of the concrete cylinder. So that's why they didn't provide that thing here. So this is another area how if we are, that's one of the reason also that if we have to model a concrete in a backers and we do not have the real stress strain curve, how can we develop our own engineering stress strain curve? Don't confuse about the engineering stress strain curve and the experimental stress strain curves. We will discuss about that in our session 3, which is material property. अच्छा ये terminologies बनाने का मकसद ये भी है कि आप साथ साथ आई नो के मोस्ट ऑफ यू आप इनको नोट कर रहे होंगे और अगर मैं कोई चीज़ भूल जाता हूँ तो वहीं पे आपने मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछना है. यू कैन आस्क दैट क्वेश्चन, वी कैन डिस्कस दैट थिंग इन डिटेल. सो दिस इज द एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप ऑफ दिस इन 1963. सो दे हैव सम एक्सटेंसोमीटर टू फाइंड आउट द चेंज इन डेप्थ इन द बीम ऑन द लेफ्ट एंड द राइट साइड्स. दे हैव द डायल गेज. This is a typical dial gauge which we used in our universities. Manual dial gauge, वो रीडिंग उसमें नोट करते थे. They applied a load from the head of testing machine, hydraulic actuator. जैसे आप समझें compression test machine के आप सामने खड़े हैं और आप load apply करते हैं from the wheel, from the lever, manually load apply करते हैं. There is no data, advanced data acquisition system, जो कि अभी हम लोग use कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे. And these are the cracks generated after the at the ultimate limit state. So this is the reason why I use this paper. So, उसी paper को मैंने थोड़ा सा screenshot to the paper तो है मौजूद आपके पास presentation में तो हम देखें. तो हमें जो foreign चीज़ें चाहिए geometry बनाने के लिए, we need the depth, we need the effective depth, we need the width, the steel ratio and the steel rebars. And also we should know the location of the load on the span. So that location divided by the depth is known as shear span ratios. Shear span ratio ko aise define karte hain, the distance from the support to the point of the loading divided by the effective depth is known as shear span ratio. Ye paper mein bhi likha hua hai, normal definition hai, phir bhi jaise revise kiya aapke samne. टाइम टेबल है ये हम ऑलरेडी देख चुके हैं इस टेबल को. एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप है हमारे पास, क्रैक पैटर्न्स हैं एंड दिस इज द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग फॉर अस, लोड डिफ्लेक्शन कर्व्स. सो इफ मोस्ट ऑफ यू नो अबाउट दैट इन कॉन्क्रीट वी हैव टू टाइप ऑफ द फेलियर, आइदर आवर बीम विल बी फेल इन फ्लेक्चर मैनर और इन शेयर मेंबर. बीम भी फेल कर सकती है फ्लेक्चर शेयर में, कॉलम, स्लैब, फाउंडेशन. सो दिस बीम स्पेशली OA ग्रुप beams, they failed in shear manner. और हमारे पास उसकी कर्व है कि बिल्कुल हमारे पास किसी किस्म की डिफॉर्मेशन नहीं है. आप C1 देखें जहाँ पे हमारे पास शेयर लिंक्स हैं, द बिहेवियर ऑफ द C1 एंड OA1 इज टोटली डिफरेंट. वी हैव सम यील्डिंग इन C1, अनलाइक वी डोंट हैव एनी यील्ड इन द OA1. सो इस अच्छा जी, आप एक और प्रॉब्लम, वी डू नॉट हैव दैट कर्व इन एक्सेल. हमने तो जब हम अबेकस से कोई कर्व लेंगे देन हाउ कैन वी प्लॉट दैट कर्व इन एक्सेल, वी कैन यूज अ स्मॉल प्रोग्राम, वो भी मैं इंशाल्लाह अभी अपलोड कर दूंगा, विच इज नोन एज गेट डाटा, और उसके ऊपर आपको ट्यूटोरियल चाहिए तो यूट्यूब पे पड़ा हुआ है, आप कहेंगे तो नेक्स्ट सेशन में मैं 5-10 मिनट उसके ऊपर भी हम लोग लगा लेंगे. दैट इफ यू नीड एनी कर्व फ्रॉम एनी फिगर अराउंड द ग्लोब द एक्चुअल कोऑर्डिनेट ऑफ दैट कर्व यू कैन फाइंड आउट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द गेट डाटा प्लॉटर. And you use that in Excel file, in MATLAB to plot your own graph, to discuss the result with the FEM results, or aap usme discussion kar sakte. Now, aap sab beshak se online rahe, we are taking a small 5-minute break. I know ke 1 hour ke baad thoda banda exhaust ho jata hai. Just have a good, aap paani shani piye. आप मेरे ऑफिस में होते हैं, आई विल ऑफर यू अ टी, तो आप टी भी पिए बिल्कुल. जस्ट अ 5 मिनट स्मॉल ब्रेक, प्लीज़ टीम से जाइएगा नहीं, टीम पे रहें आप लोग और थोड़ा सा रिलैक्स होके आएँ. जो चीज़ें मैंने आपके साथ शेयर की हैं, जो पॉइंट्स हैं उनको आप नोट कर सकते हैं इस 5 मिनट ब्रेक में. जस्ट रिलैक्स योर सेल्फ, रिलैक्स योर माइंड, और अब उसके बाद जैसे मैं आता हूँ इंशाल्लाह अराउंड वी विल ज्वाइन अगेन अराउंड इन अराउंड 14:05 2:05 पे हम दोबारा ज्वाइन करेंगे आपको और टीम पे मैं आ जाऊँगा इंशाल्लाह ताला और फिर हम लोग दोबारा आएंगे. आप लोग जो टीम पे रहना चाहते हैं बिल्कुल टीम पे रहें, यू कैन डू योर ओन वर्क. रिकॉर्डिंग को मैं यहाँ पे स्टॉप कर रहा हूँ, बल्कि नहीं हम रिकॉर्डिंग को चलने देते हैं, बाद में इसको फिर एडिट कर लेंगे इंशाल्लाह. सो स्टिल बिफोर गोइंग टू एक्चुअल स्टार्ट द अबेकस, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन राइट नाउ, एनी टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द मॉड्यूल, फ्रॉम द अबेकस, आउटसाइड द मॉड्यूल, प्लीज आस्क मी, सो डैट जब आप अबेकस में मेरे साथ स्टेप बाय स्टेप फॉलो कर रहे हो हैंड ऑन ट्रेनिंग, तो यू विल बी वर्किंग विथ मी इन द नेक्स्ट 1 hour विथ फ्री माइंड. आपके पास कोई ऑक्यूपाइड ना हो कि यार ये सवाल मैंने पूछा नहीं सर से, या ये हम डिस्कस कर लेते, ये समय में नहीं आई. सो प्लीज रेज योर हैंड अगेन, प्लीज आस्क मी एनी क्वेश्चन, अदरवाइज वी विल ज्वाइन इन 10 मिनट्स स्टार्ट वर्किंग ऑन द अबेकस राइट नाउ. ओके, सो मेन टाइम जिन लोगों ने बैकअप इंस्टॉल किया हुआ है अपना बैकअप आप ओपन कर लें, और जो भी पेपर आपके सामने हैं उसको आप करें. मैं भी आपको थोड़ा सा ग्राफिक की तरफ भी लेके जाऊंगा, और जस्ट वेट फॉर मी, जस्ट गिव मी 5 मिनट शॉर्ट ब्रेक, आप लोग भी ब्रेक लें. आई एम गोइंग टू म्यूट माई सेल्फ एंड देन आई विल अनम्यूट माई सेल्फ अराउंड 14:05. थैंक यू. वेलकम बैक। शॉर्ट ब्रेक जो है ना इंसान के माइंड और बॉडी के लिए बड़ी जरूरी है। ओके, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मॉडल आवर केस स्टडी फॉर द मॉड्यूल वन। सो आई सिलेक्टेड OA1 बीम फ्रॉम द प्रोफेसर ब्रसेल एंड सोलगालिस as a case study modeling in our Abacus module 1. So what I need, just I convert, as I told you that I am more comfortable. Just hold on, I just share the screen or share. Regarding, okay. Okay. So I just selected OA1 from the paper, and I, as I told you that I am more comfortable with the SI units, so I'm going to convert all the systems, all the units in SI units. So this is my conversion sheet. So I need to draw a beam of width of 310 millimeter, with a depth of 550, with the effective depth of 470 after reducing the clear cover. I know all of you know about the clear cover. The bottom cover is up to 64. So this is the same value, or just make it, this is the same value. The bottom cover is 64. The vertical distance between the layers. So what are our layers? So these are our two layers. Vertical distance will be 64 and the horizontal distance will be 178. So now I'm going to draw that thing in front of you so that you can understand that how many information I required to draw the same model in my Abacus. So I have by using the OneNote, I created the module 1 in this team. First, understand that we have a beam. So this is my beam. The red dots are my donuts, are my reinforcement. This is 310 millimeter. The total depth is 470 and 544. Okay, so this is my cross section of my beam which I require to model in Abacus. So what I need this point, I need this point and this point. These four points I need in Abacus. If I define these four points, then I can draw the cross section. After that we'll come to the rebars. Now I had a past experience for teaching the softwares at different levels, also in UK, in Pakistan, in Texas University. What I learned from the experience that when you have a new software, when you have a new tool, you have a lot of questions. What is this? How can I use section? What is the purpose of that rendered model hidden? What is the purpose of this cutting plane? Don't confuse yourself. Just in the first phase, just follow the steps. So I will request all of you, just follow my steps in the first go. When you will finish a single job, when you run it completely successfully, then in the future, by spending more time in that software, that software will become the part of your blood. Then you know, you can experiment with anything. You can change any geometry. You can change any material property, because then you will be familiar with all this, all the atmosphere of the Abacus. So please, in the first step, just follow the point, the focus point on which we are here. Now the parts, if I just click, so as I told you, this is my model tree. So as I just click on the parts, now the parts tab will be appear, modeling space. So are you going to draw 3D, 2D and axonometry? Okay, from here you can see that maybe it is a 2D, but remember we have the length, and the length, what is the value of the length? The length is 3658. 3658. Don't forget about the units. All units of the dimension are in millimeters. Okay. So we'll use 3D. What is the purpose of the 2D? Asymmetric. Don't worry about these things. Once you complete the module one, then in module 2, we will discuss all the remaining portion. Also, in the type, you have four different properties. Either your member is deformable, discrete rigid, analytical rigid, ailerin. For these types, obviously, our concrete is not as deformable as the form in the kitchen, the form which we use for the washing the dishes. It's not that deformable. But yes, our concrete is deformable. We have the strain property in concrete, shear strain, the linear strain property in concrete. We have the torque, the twist angle in our concrete. Yes, under the high loads, our reinforced concrete going to be twist in some direction. So we are using deformable type. Now, what about the shape? Is it solid, shell, wire, and point? Right now, my 3D beam, so I'm going to write this name, giving a name is BC Beam Concrete 1. Why 1? I will tell you later on. What happened? Faisal Javed. So, okay. So now, I renamed the model with the BC 1, the solid shell, wire and point. So I'm using the solid one. Now, from the shape, after the shape selection, we have three types. Either our beam has the revolutions, sweeps, or just simple extrusion. Why revolution is here? Why sweep is here? I'm working on a project with a design firm where the architect used the twisting beams to attract its structure more, to make structure more attractive towards the audience. So now, if you see the skyscrapers in Dubai, in States, they have using the twisting geometry just to differentiate themselves with the conventional designing. So, but now here we will use only solid. So again, I'm going to 3D, deformation, solid. These are the three checks. The last one is the approximation size of our drying area. Right now, I'm just taking 1000. Why 1000? Because my beam depth is 500 millimeter. So just take twice. And what that mean? Just I will tell you. So when you click it on continues, so you will appear a graph. So if you zoom out, so this is your drawing area. You can easily draw outside that thing, no problem with the backers, but that drawing area give you a graph. A small part has a 10 millimeter in here. The small scale is 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter. Okay. Now, when I click the continuous, now another tab is appear in the module, under the module tree. That tab is totally different with respect to the previous one. So just keep the cursor. For example, the plus sign mean create isolated point. Are we interested to draw small point? No. Create lines. Yes, we need a line. We need at least four lines to create a concrete beam. Circle? No. Right now, we don't interested about the circle. Rectangle, yes, we can use rectangle because our geometry is a rectangle. So either we will use line and geometry, line or the rectangular options. Just leave the other options. We will come back to these options one by one in our coming modules. Now, first, I will differentiate how we can use the line and the rectangle. So if you click the line, that means it's a series of connected line, maybe more than four, maybe more than 10. But when you click on the rectangle, it's a rectangle lines, and you can see four lines. You cannot draw by using this option. You cannot draw any object having more than four lines. Okay, that four lines is not necessary be a rectangle, which is other. It can be a rhombus, it can be a diamond, but it should be four lines. So first I will use the create line option. Just select create line option, and the bar is appear. So you know that our origin is here 0 0, as is appear on the top, the x and y is changing. So the origin is 0 0. This is my positive coordinate and the negative coordinates, and you know about the rest. So if I use any draw anything here, it will come back, it will draw here. If you see the tutorials on the YouTube, most of the YouTubers, they draw the center of the object with the center of the coordinates. That confused me a lot. I'm not using that kind of approach. I will use the origin of the graph as my this point. So can you see my screen? Can you see the, can you easily read the numerical values?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So what I'm going to do, so that will be my 0 0, okay? So if this is 0 0, what will be the coordinate of that system? The x will be 3 10, and the y will be 0. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, this is the stream coordinate, which is 3 10 in x direction and 5 5. I make it 5, just 5. It will not change, it will not affect my geometry, but it will be more round off thing. So 5 5 5, okay? What will be the coordinate of that thing? X is 0 and the y is 5 5 5. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Now just go here. You can choose points here like this, but that will be more complex. Maybe you have some error and you never know. So just choose line option and come into the pick a starting point in the tab here. The first coordinate is 0x, 0y. Just enter, it will appear here. After giving me the response, please unmute your mic. So 0 0, I define 0 0. So I will go from right, I will go to the right, up and the left. Okay, that will be the order. So the next point will be 3 10 x with 0 y. The third point will be 3 10 x with the capital with the y of 555, and the fourth point will be 0 x with 555, and the last point will be 0 0. So you can see this is my cross section of the beam. Okay, it is lying outside my graph area, no problems. This is my intention, and I use the line, four line option, by having the coordinates, and I can easily draw the cross section here. It's no problem there, okay? After that, just make a cross. Are you done? Yes, we define our cross section. Just done it. And now in the depth, okay, the depth is here, is basically the length. But sir, we already defined the depth of the beam, which is 555. That depth is vertical axis for a backers. The depth meaning for the backers is the depth inside the screen, perpendicular to the screen face. So debt will be, what will be the value of that debt is 365. So I'm just taking 3660, okay? Just round of values for more accuracy. 3660. So that concrete beam is just a pier. Don't confuse, it has a gray color, so it's mean concrete. No, the gray color in abacus mean that that member is without any property. How can we define concrete? How can we define property? We will discuss later on. Today's focus about the geometry. Okay, so this is one thing. Now I'm going, so now I just repeat the step with you with the different approach. Just go with the part one again. Name BC to 3D, yes. Deformable, yes. Solid, yes. Extrusion, yes. Approximately 7000, yes. Just continues. But this time choose the rectangle, the quickest way. For the rectangle, it will ask me the starting corner of the rectangle. Obviously, it is 0, 0. Now, it is ask me pick the opposite corner. So we have four corners. I define that corner, the opposite corner, that corner, not this one, not this one. So that corner will be 3, 10, 5, 5. The diagonal corner, 3, 1, 0, 5, 5. Again, the answer will be the same. Make the cross check. Say done, 3660 the length, and you will get the same results. So these are the two approach. Whatever approach you want to use, you can use it. It's just for your revision so that we can model different. We can model our beam in different way. Okay. So this is the part one. Now, the total length of the beam is 366, whereas the length of the steel bar is not 366. Why? Because I have a clear cover on this side and I have the clear cover on this side. And that clear cover will be equal to the bottom clear cover, 64 inches. So what I have to do, I just select here, select 366, minus 64, minus 64. Okay, I'm just changing some parameters. So used 310, 555, 470, 65, 65, 186, and the 1210. Minus 65 from left side, 65 from the right side. So I need a steel bar of 3530. Agree? Now, how can I define the steel bar here? Just go back again, steel bar. Name the parts as your component, because in a backer, during the calibration procedure, maybe you make for a one small beam, you make 20 samples. You forget about the parts name. So play smartly. Name each, every note so that after 5 years, I still remember if you ask me, I completed my PhD in 2018, start working with the Abacus in 2015. If you ask me, just open your October 2015 model on the beam, on the same beam, I will just add, open that model. I have that model with me and I will just go and explain with you each and every single step, because putting the time on that thing, putting your energy, that will be become just like your blood. So now the steel bar. Now it is 3D. Yes, it is 3D. Deformable. Yes, deformable. But this time it is wire, planar. It is not shell. It is not point. It is wire. 1000, don't care about it, 1000. Continues. Now it's a steel bar. So we know that our steel bar look like, how it look like? 8530. Okay. So that will be the left clear cover, the right clear cover, the bottom clear cover. I try my best to draw as neat as possible, but I'm still learning the graphite tablet. Hopefully with your support, with your help, I will improve myself on that thing. So I just need 3530. What about the laps? We are not going to draw the lap. Why? I will tell you later on, not right now. So again, we do not need this time rectangular. We need the line. That's why I show you the two methods to draw the rectangular shape, the closed shape. This is not the closed shape. So just this, the first point 0, 0, and the second point, the X will be, how much will be the X? 3530, 0, 0. Done. Because this is a, so now when we done, in the previous step, they asked me the depth. We already defined the depth. So in that one, by having the wire section, it didn't ask us the depth. Done. So this is our steel bar. Sir, what is the area of that steel bar? I don't know. We didn't define that thing right now. What is the yield strength? Hold on. Just wait for a couple of sessions. How can we do the meshing? How can we embed that steel bar in our concrete, in our this module? Just hold on. Everything will be there. Just wait. So this is the steel bar. Now, after the part, we have the material property. We are not going to define material. We are not going to define section, the profile. We are just going towards directly jump to the assembly. Why assembly? Because in the first module, the session one will be discussed about the basic geometry modeling. We done it right now. The assembly will do it right now. And the surface interactions and the bonding conditions. Okay. Now, before going to the assembly, just go back to your paper. And you can see here that the experimental setup have us at the bottom of the bar, bottom of the supports, we have a steel bearing, spherical bearing block. And for the top, we have the load bearing block. So these are the steel plates. So these steel plates are, we are used, the researcher use these steel plates commonly so that the steel, the load in a form of a point distributed on the whole beam and the steel has a good grip. So that's the purpose. So we have to define that steel plate right now. Now, what will it be our steel plate? How it would like? From the paper, we do not have any idea. We will use it on based on our experience. So now, what will be the steel plate? Your width will be 310. Okay. So what I suggest to take a steel plate. Having width of 310. The other dimension is also 310 and the height of 200 millimeter, the thickness of this steel plate. Okay. Where I got this thing, when I did that thing from the experiment, from experience, I know that steel plate will be work. If that will be not work, we will just change the steel plate, no matter. Now, for the steel plate, just go back to your parts, click part, click steel plate. Right now, I am using the same cross-section area, same geometric cross-section area for the top of steel bar, where top of the steel plate, where I apply the load, and the bottom of the steel plates, where my beam is rested on as a support plates. So I use the same thing for both the loading, for the applied load and for the reactions. 3D done, deformed done, solid. It's a 3D member, done. I will use rectangular quickly. 0, 0. Remember the depth is 310. So if the depth is 310, so what I need else? 310 and 200. 310 200, 310. The depth and the length of the steel plate and the width of the steel plates are same. I have to put the same steel plate having the depth, having the width of the steel plate equal to the beam. If we use small, it has their own problem. If we use large, it has own problem. So this is the steel plate, okay? Now the assembly phase. Just go. Okay, I have BC1, BC2, so I'm, and we know the BC1, BC2, they are both identical, only the way are to define them, etc. So I'm just going to do delete it here to so I don't have any confusions. Now the BC1, beam concrete, steel plate, steel bar. Now just leave the rest, just follow the steps and go to the assembly. In the assembly, click the instance options. Now, when you click the instance options, it will, all the parts which you defined in the parts, that will be appear here. If I have more 5 parts, that will be appear here. Model, do I want to import any model from my previous research in that assembly? We will do that thing, but we are not right doing right now. So BC1, steel plate, steel bar. Instance type, dependent mesh on parts, independent mesh. Always use independent mesh. Why? Hold on. In the second lecture, I will request one of my colleague who has a 15 year experience on the meshing. He did his PhD on the meshing problems during the FEM analysis, different type of the meshing. I request him. Please give us some time on the Wednesday, 6 o'clock. To describe about some meshing. So I hope if he joined us, otherwise I will play his recorded video message to you. Or if both will be not possible, then I will read his notes in front of you to understand the mesh, because he's the expert of the mesh. I still remember in 2015, I took a lot of help from him. And right now he's working as a general manager in a classified organization. Independent mesh and instance. So just use this one. Okay. What is the error? A part must be selected. Oh, we forget to select a part. So just select a beam part. As you see, I just select the beam part. In my background, the beam part will be appear. No, I just want to upload the import the steel plate. No, steel bar. Okay, go with the steel beam. Done. So this is the steel beam. Now, these axes are the view axes. The green, Y, red, X, blue, Z. And these are my global axis, the yellow one. So right now, my local beam axis, my origin of the beam, is lie at the origin of the local axis. So remember, the final students of the BSc and the master students in structure analysis, your teacher torture you with the global axis, local axis, member axis, structure axis, small LM, capital LM, from the stiffness matrix, from the flexible matrix. At that time, we did not know that application. This is the real application of that course. Okay, that done. What's the next thing? Just select, view. So when I change the view, so this is my 3D view, XY, the cross section, XY, top view, bottom view, left view, right view, and 3D view. Okay? Now, the other part, before going to the other part, the steel bars or the steel plates, I do not know where I have to put my steel plate. Okay, I know that the support connection. Okay, just first we just import the steel plates. So just go here again. Steel plates, independent mesh, done. But what happened? The steel plate is merged with the beam. So just now going to height beam. So when I do the height beam, it will appear at bottom. Now the local and the global axis of the beam Again, they are same. So remember, whenever import the, in the start, whenever import a member part, just make sure that the local and the global edges are same. In here, I can do rename, show, delete, surplus, parents, children's, make dependents, what they are, we'll discuss one by one. Right now, I'm just use the hide and show button. So this is now visible to all of us. Now, we need some reference points. What are the reference point? The reference point help us during the geometry. The reference point help us to, you know, to draw the things more accurately. So for example, this is my point, which is 0, 0. The center of the beam. So this is the center of the beam where I want to put my steel plate. Again, accept my apologies for the bad drawings. I am still learning the graphite tablet. And then I need some point for my steel bar. Remember, if the cross section is here, I need 1, 2, 3, 4 points, okay? Now, how can I define these points so that my geometry is very accurate, very near to the experimental setup? Just go to the tools. In tools, you have reference point, attachment, set, surface, partition, datum. What are these? Right now, just hold on, just focus about the datum. In the datum, create datum point at the reference point. Are you want to create axis, planes, global SYS? No, I'm interested to develop some points. Enter coordinate, yes, enter coordinate. So what will be the first coordinate? I want to develop the first coordinate 0, 0, 0. So all will be 0.0, x, 0.0, y, 0.0, z. So when I just click enter, you will see a small dot appear here. So this is my one point. I also want to produce one more point at here where I just put my cursor. Okay, what will be the x of this point? It is 0. What will be the y of this point? Again, 0. What will be the z? That will be the length of the beam. Remember the length of the beam, 3660. 3660, enter. So my another point, can you see the another point here? So this is another point which I just got it here. Now, I am just taking half of the beam. It's always good. What I did, I make a Excel sheet. I put everything from the paper, from my research paper, put here as the examples or the figures, and make my own Excel sheet for the dimension so that in future, if I need to change anything, I will just go there. So the center of the steel plate responsible to transfer the load will be 1830Z. But that time, that will be the top. Now, what will be the, so this is the top point, okay? So what will be the X? Remember, X is here, 0. What will be the Y? The total depth, remember, 310. What will be the Z? 1830. Oh, I did some mistake. So when you're creating a points, these points are created here. This is your first point, highlighted by red. This is your second point. This is your third point. Third point has some problem. What is the problem? The Y is 310. I use 310, which is the width of the beam. The depth of the beam is 555. So this is the mistake. And I did it by intentionally. So you know that if you can change the point, you can change it easily. Apply. Now it's okay. Done. So this is the geometry references which I needed here. Okay. At that time, I'm just going to draw the steel plates points, okay? The points which I need for the steel bars. I'm just enlarging the small size here to this here, okay? Remember, this point is 3100. This point is 00. This is my first RB steel bar, second steel bar, third steel bar, fourth steel bar. I know each distance between these forces, okay? From where? From the paper. So this is the paper. 2.5 inch from the bottom, 2.5 inch between two bars, 7 inches between the two horizontal bars. But we are working the millimeter. So 65 from the bottom, 65 from another point, and 180 with the horizontal point. Okay. Now, all this note, one note point will be available for you for your references in case you will forget. So what will be now, I will write my new coordinates. Okay. This is from here, I up, I will go up 65, sorry, go horizontal 65 and up 65. From 00, this is 65, 65. From this point, little bit tricky, okay? The total length is 310. So minus 310 with the 65. All this point with R with from 00 with that pin dot, okay? Don't forget about this. So the X will be, how much will be X? 245. What will be the Y? 65. Again, what will be the X? 245. What will be the Y? This is 65. This is 65, the total will be 130. What is this? X 65, what will the Y? 135. So I don't, in that case, I don't need this thing. So let's define these four points, 65, 65. You can go with the feature or you can go with the tools datum, enter coordinates. Now, X 65, Y 65 and the Z is also 65, the clear cover which we counted for the long bar, 65, 65. So you see, bar is appear here, the dot will be appear here, okay? Another dot will be .245, 65, and 65. Now, 65, 130, 65, 65, 130, 245. Is it 245? Yes, 245. Again, I'm doing some mistake, yep. So that point is correct, this point is wrong, this point is wrong. Okay, that point will be okay. 65. From here, the X will be 65, the Y will be 130. The Z will be, so this is the point, 65, 65 then, 65, 245. So I change x. Okay. So you can play with that. You can change the geometry. So now you can see. So which face you want to see? The front face. Don't forget to save after some time, because sometime the backers will be misbehave. So these are our reference points. Now, just highlight everything. Open the steel plate, show. Now, you want to remember that this is your point, the bottom of the beam, the our reference point. We want to shift that steel plate at the bottom, because the steel plate should be at the bottom of the beam, not at the top, like here. This is the steel plates, okay? How can I transfer it? Just like this thing, In here, if you see the assembly, you have new tap again. So every time you select here, you have new tap here. Every time you select anything, you will select new things, okay? So don't worry about it. The first thing, create instance, we did it. That's duplicate radial, and that's translate instance, and you can see with the error we can translate with each other. Just like this, select the whole structure, select the instance to translate. Yes, I want to translate it. I want to shift it from where? From this point to this point. Done. So what I selected? I selected the top of the beam, top of the plate, and I shift it with the bottom. So that how it look like, how it should look like. Okay. Now, as in ETAP and INSAP, we have the replication option. So yes, we have the same thing in a backers. We want to replicate the same steel plate two times here and here. So select the this linear pattern. Which one? You want to do the replication with the beam? No. With the steel plate? Yes, steel plate. Done. It should be one. It should be two. With a 500. On which side? Select this, this line. So what are these? When are you going to duplicate? You need, how do you want to duplicate? For example, right now I just selected direction 2, which is my this direction. I can just select with this arrow. I can flip it here, either here or here. If I can increase this thing 2, he will ask me the axis. I will say my this axis. So right now I am repeating the same steel plate into the 6, 2 into 3 into the 6, including the original one. Do I need the 6 plates? No. So just 3 plates, done. Again, now it's very easy to translate the things. Select that thing, select this structure, select top of this thing to the to this point, done. But that will be at the top and in the middle. So just rotate the beam. So now I want to translate that bottom bar, the middle point, at this middle point. Look, how can I do it? Select translate, select the object, then which point? End point? No. This point? No. Middle point? Yes. Up to this point, which we already defined. Done. So this is my problem. Now you can see, if you see steel plate one, this is steel plate one, one line, one repetition. If you want to change the name, okay, otherwise leave it down, no problem with that lumbrings. Now the last thing, steel bar. So now I'm going to provide the steel bar. This is a very common problem, that your steel bar is not in the axis, it's like this one. No issue. I put it intentionally so that we can learn more. Now we have two problems. The one problem, the steel bar origin is at the global origin. So this is steel bar having at the global region. We can know how to solve this problem. So this is not problem, any problem. So this is not any more problem for us. But we want to translate that, we want to rotate that axis of this bar with respect to the longitudinal beam. That is a new problem for us, and we have to learn about it. So now, after the translate instance, you have rotate instance. Click this one. Do you want to rotate steel plate? No. Beam? No. Just like the steel bar. Done. Which axis? Select the start point. Take it 000. Select an end point. Let's play. First, we want to rotate it along x axis. So we'll put 1x, 0y, 0z. At the end of 90 degree. Done. It didn't change. Oh, no problem. Again, 0, 0, done. Now 0x, 1y, 0z, 90 degree. Yes. Oh, we found the correct axis. So if you forget y, because we want to rotate it along the y, not x, not z. Now it's in the alignment with the concrete. Now we have to just translate it, which is very easy for us. You know it. So that's how. And now how we can translate it? Just hide the beam because it's confusing us. And select the point, translate point. We want to translate steel bar from this point to which point? The origin point? No. Top point? Yes, but we will start with this point. So that our point. Now, we have the same steel plate, steel bar in our four axis. Now we want to duplicate it. Again, use the linear one. Linear. Select the instance. We want to duplicate the steel bar. We know the distance between these two vertical. It is, what is the distance? The distance is 180. So mention 180 here. In which direction? Select this. In this direction. Number of bars just increased to. So you can see you have two bars here. So you can see one bar here. Can you see another bar on the same point which we defined? Now, we know the vertical distance also, which is 65. What distance? The x, the y distance. Click y, it is already in y, but the distance will be not 165, it is 65. So when you just click it, so it will be coming down here. Show beam, hide beam, individual. Sir, if we have to use the duplicate bars, then why we have to provide the four coordinates? Because you never know. In a problem, you have all bar having the same diameter, or maybe the all four bars having a different diameter, then what will be you do? So I will teach you the both method. If you define the single point as having the same four identical bars, you can do that thing, or you can do the conventional method, define each point separately. So now this is my beam. This is, I can see different, see different renders views. That's the thing going to save my problem. So where I was here, did I complete the one? No, because the first part will take a lot of things. So I will cover the basic geometry assembly up to this point. What about with the surface interaction and the meshing? We will cover these two remaining parts in the next session. Now I am just saving my model. Saving this presentation in PDF file, you will be assessed from your team. please kindly check your team. Now, if you have any questions, we have another 10 minutes. I can just take your quick questions.